side. Here, as in the great tradition of all armies, the colours are value and maintained with a colour guard to the rear. The sharpshooters are out there in skirmish order, the main body of infantry behind them. The object of the infantry to bring mass fire to bear on the enemy as quickly as possible. To fire first, to be faster with our most guns. We have a small skirmish line of Union soldiers coming out now. Union infantrymen were also taught to skirmish, to spread out in an open formation. The field's very tight under normal battlefield circumstances. There will be a bigger interval between the soldiers.
Rally on the reserve.
Skirmishers have been called in to rally on the reserve. You'll notice hundreds of skirmishers rallying into four. Like a mini square.
I wish somebody learned him how to blow up the
ovens. You can almost fight cavalry off with it.
I wish somebody learned him how to blow up on.
Look at the sharpshooters. Fast, highly mobile.
Yeah, they've got 3-8 engines.
They don't normally fight in ranks. But today, for your edification and entertainment, we pull the entire Union battle line into one. It's a slow process loading a musket. Nine separate loading motions. 10 if you're a Confederate. The soldiers are preparing to fire by rank.
They only cover one.
Juliet!
What was a Roman candle, were you?
What we call a hand fire in one of the muskets. Gunpowder is hygroscopic. It absorbs water, even from an atmosphere like this. When these soldiers have finished firing, out of the muzzle of the musket, black junk appears on however dry a day. The only time I have ever seen this not happen was in America in 110 degree heat. It was calculated during the American Civil War that you needed 240 kilograms of black powder and 435 kilograms of lead to kill one man. And there's a reason for that. The preferred weapon of the Americans before the American Civil War was barrel shotguns.